You, my child, you shall go out and become a protector of the world. You, my son, will defend mankind and do your family proud. Yeah, about that, Dad. You ever been to Tokyo? Again, we're gonna look into some craft work. There's three crafts I'm gonna get into, one of which is ironing patches onto your jacket or your shirt or whatever when you're going to promote what you're into. Another one is scrapbooking. Don't laugh, it can be fun. Just have to find the subject you enjoy scrapbooking about. And the third one is perler beads, and I know a lot of people don't even know what that is. If you're into 8-bit games, it can be higher bit, like 32, maybe even 64, but it's really easiest with the 8-bits. You can have a lot of fun with perler beads. Now, this is what I'm working on right now. These are going to be a gift for a friend of mine who's recently graduated. It's three Pokemon. I can't remember what the first two names are, but the last one is an Umbreon. And I've hit a snag because I've run out of a specific color. I think it's dark gray. I might be low on some other colors. So I've had to stop mid-project. And that's a common thing when I'm working with perler beads. You have to stop mid-project. So what I've done was whatever was left out of the other colors I finished up with. And I still have some spare dark blue that's going to go onto a third Pokeball. And I'm going to go out tomorrow and pick up some fresh colors and try to finish this stuff. It's got to be done tomorrow because that's when it's needed. So I'm going to put them together tomorrow and I will show you that process, and hopefully they will be done in time. That's that. This is going to be an overtime video. We're going to see a finished product and then show you a little bit more of how those are made. So through the power of editing and the passage of time, let's go straight to that. Okay guys, it is now the day after, and I've stopped by the local craft store. Was Joann Fabrics is usually the best place I can find this stuff for. And you pick up these pouches. There's 1,000 beads in one pouch, and they come in different colors, but there's always like the one color in the pouch, with some exceptions. So I picked up some dark gray and some, what is the other one? Some light blue. So says the pouch. And we're going to get to work finishing this up. Now I use a pen because the pen tip will fit in the hole of the bead. Kind of like that. You see that? The little bead. And then you put it in the pin. And then you put it in the pegboard. And I turned into something just now. I don't know what that was. And then, we're going to do something kind of tricky with these. Well, maybe it's not tricky, but I think a lot of people just don't think of it when they go and do it. We're going to make these figures, these two-dimensional figures, actually stand up on a little base. And sometimes, like, the things you're using to stand them up on isn't really strong enough to hold it. So what I do is I get some of the clear beads, or at least they're supposed to be clear, and I put those around the spot I've picked to actually have them stand up. And I use that as a kind of strengthener to be able to hold them up better. And then we go and put it together. And we're going to go take a look at how that looks. And then I'm going to show you what the end result looks like. So I'll see you in some time. So, yeah. We've just put the stuff together, and when that's done, you very carefully put a piece of kind of tracing paper. You can find these at the craft stores right next to the beads. It's a special kind of paper. You lay over it very carefully because you don't want to move any of the beads. And then you take an iron and you push that over the paper to melt the beads together so they fuse together. That's why sometimes these are called fusion beads. But something else that came up, and I just realized I never finished this, so I have to fix it a little bit, but I'll take care of that. Sometimes you'll have a piece that you don't have room on the grid for. They'll have little grids that you put the beads on, and sometimes you just want to have space for it. So what you got to do is, sometimes that'll happen. So like you'll have room to make it all, but you won't have room to put it all together in one piece. So what you do is, just go ahead and make the other piece that won't fit where it's supposed to. And then when it's solid like this, both pieces are solid, you can just put them back on the grid and iron those two pieces together. It's really simple. But you have to be careful. You cannot iron too hard or too long, because if you do, it's going to get too thick and you're going to have a lot of problems. For one, it won't go on the grid the way you want it to. And for two, it'll fill up so that you can't even iron it properly. And third, the pieces will not fit together the way you want them to. Sometimes you just actually have to take a scissors and trim the edges of where you've ironed to get them to fit. Hopefully we won't have to do that here, but we're going to do that, and then I'm going to show you what the final product looks like. Alright guys, a little more explanation. I put all my beads in these things because it's most of the time easier to store them. Once you're done ironing the beads, you're going to see that they will try to bulge up, like they will warp. So you need to keep them flat while they're cooling. So I'll put one or two of these down on top of them and just let them cool. And that'll take a little bit, but it'll get done. And when you're done doing that, be sure to be careful where you put your container, because it's going to be hot on the bottom. And make sure you put paper on both sides when you iron the other side. You want to iron both sides, so you iron the first side while it's still on the grid. Then you flip them all over, make sure there's paper under them, and then iron the other side to get them nice and solid on both ends. So then you carefully want to peel off the paper, and I did not do it carefully enough, or this is just too old paper. But we're peeling it off, and this is older paper because a piece of the paper did not make it off, so we got to scrape that off. And if you have paper with a hole in it, I don't know if you can see that, the paper is now useless. Because any holes are going to cause you a lot of problems, and we do not need problems right now. And I'll pick that up later, Mom. So, let's see if we got any of these to work right. Yay! This is Umbreon on his display stand. And it looks like that. And it's pretty fun to do these, especially when nobody else really thinks of them, because I see these sell a lot of the time, like perler beads at conventions and stuff, but nobody thinks to try to stand them up or something like that. They don't try to think outside the box. So it's a lot of fun, and what you want to do, please don't rip me off, even though I know some people are going to, because it's karma. When you make the peg part to stick in the base, what you basically do is make the whole base first, and then decide where you're going to want to put your stand, and take those pieces out, and then just put them on the bottom so that when you plug it in, the colors will match up. And that's a good way of knowing which base goes to which Pokemon. Or like just a numbers game, like this one's missing a set amount. And this Pokemon clearly goes in that one because it's got the same amount on its base. And there's another one, I think that's Vilipede? I can't remember. But there's more paper on him, so we're going to scrape that off. And sometimes it's easier than other times to get the papers off. The newer the paper, the better the quality, the easier it's going to be to get it off. But paper will age over time, and it just won't work after long enough time. So you got to keep replacing the paper. And then we've got this one. I don't even remember what this dude's name is. And another warning, if you have pets, I don't know about other pets, but cats, you're going to get hair on these. So you want to be extra cautious to like get the hairs off the beads before you iron them, because once you iron them, if you're lucky if they're sticking out at the ends and you can try to just pluck them off,
But a lot of the time, they're ironed into the plastic, and you're never getting them off. So, that is how you do the perler beads. We also have the patches and the scrapbook. And then I have one other surprise at the end of the video that I'm not going to show you how to make it yet because I have to find more supplies. But I am going to show you what the end result is first, and I think you guys are going to like it. So I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed making it. And so that's it, I guess. So until next time, this is the Geek saying, good journey.
Next time on Obscure Reviews.